Once again, a welcome back to your online classes, students. Students, in last session, we are discussing about the chapter, the January night. I have already discussed about its characters. There was three characters were there, Munni, Halku and Jabra. Munni and Halku both were the farmer and they were very poor. And Halku came to his house and he is asking some money from from his wife to give to the landlord, and his wife is not ready to give the money. So there was a discussion between both of them, and she was not agreed to pay the ransom, or red debt, because the season was winter season and there was no blanket, and Halku needs a blanket to protect the field, and when he will sleep in field there is need for the blanket, and if they will pay 3 rupees to the landlords, there is no way to purchase blankets. So how Halku will survive? Now next, what will happen? Let's see. Trying to coax her, he said, "Come on, give it to me. Well, we'll manage. I'll figure out some other plans to get the blanket." His wife was not trying to give the money, but he was trying to ask, and he was trying to get the money from her, from his wife. And he said, "Ki, you don't worry. I'll manage something else to for the blanket." Munni drew away from him. Her eyes angry. She said, "You just tell me what other plan can be found. If somebody is going to give you a blanket, God knows how many debts are always left over that we can pay off. What I say is give up the tenant farming. The work is killing you. Whatever you harvest goes to pay up the arrears. So why you not finish with it? Earn some money from your own belly. For your own belly, I won't give you the money I want." The lady was very angry, and she was asking a lot of questions, ki who will give you the blanket, God knows why you are doing this, numbers of debts are there, so how we can pay off that, a lot of questions are there, and she was asking, generally she was asking to asking to the Halku, and Halku was stable, he was thinking about the debt which he have to give to the landlords. Sadly, Halku said, "Then I'll have to put up with this, his abuse." And when his wife said that, "I will not give you money," then with the facial, the sidle expressions, he said, "No problem. If you will not give me money, I'll have to put up with his abuse. मुझे उसकी गालियों से ही संतोष करना पड़ेगा, यानी मुझे उसके बकायदार की गाली मुझे सुननी पड़ेगी." The bitter truth in Halku's word came charging at Munni like a wild beast. और ये जो कड़वी सच्चाई जो हल्कू की निकली, उससे उस मुन्नी को चार्ज कर दिया, और मुन्नी एक वाइल्ड बीस्ट की तरह, जंगली और की तरह दौड़ते हुए गई, अंदर गई. She went to the edge in the wall, took out the rupees and handed them over the Halku. Then he said, "Give up farming this time. If you work as a hard labor, you will at least get enough food to eat for it. Fine work farming someone else's land." उसकी वाइफ दीवार से कुछ पैसे निकाल के ले आती है, उसको देती है और कहती है, इफ़ ये अभी अब फार्मिंग क्या कर दो, अभी आप छोड़ दो, जो अपनी खेती वो छोड़ दो, किसी दूसरे के यहाँ अगर जॉब करते हैं तो हमको इनफ पैसे मिलेंगे, इससे हमारे खाने पीने की व्यवस्था अच्छी हो सकती है. इस टाइम ये सब चीज़ें अपनी खेती के बारे में सोचना छोड़ दो. Halku took the money and went outside looking so as though he were tearing his heart out of giving it away. He had saved the rupees for his work piece by piece for his blanket. Today he was going to throw it away. With every step his head sank lower under the burden of his poverty. Halku paise leke kafi dukhi man se ghar se bahar nikla, aur usne ye paise पाई पाई करके जोड़े हुए थे एक ब्लैंकेट खरीदने के लिए, लेकिन आज उसको वो उसको देने जा रहा है, और उसको अपनी गरीबी पे काफ़ी गुस्सा भी आ रहा है और काफ़ी दुख भी है कि वो इतना गरीब क्यों है. सो स्टूडेंट्स, नेक्स्ट पार्ट विल डिस्कस व्हाट हैपेंड लेटर ऑन इन दिस.